Today, we're going to bring you into the world of biogas digestion. The whole idea is to create methane, just like you do in your stomach as you're churning up your food, and one of the byproducts is methane. Here, we're going to show you today four different ways you can go as simple or as high-tech as you want to go with this. Here's one real simple method right here, where you take two cylinders, and as, you know, you put food waste and your, you know, manure and everything else in there, and as it churns up, the methane bubbles to the top and forces that upper cylinder up, which is good for several purposes. It holds the methane, it pressurizes the methane so you can send it back to your utilities or whatever you're going to use it with. So you put in your rotten vegetables and your manure and, you know, whatever you got ground up, you put it in here. This isn't built yet, but you'll get the idea. And it goes down to the bottom, and as the methane builds up under this chamber, it raises up slowly like this until it would eventually fall off. So you build a cage to keep it from falling off, and then as you use it, as you turn your cook stove on or your generator, this thing goes back down, like so. This is kind of a proof of concept. Right here, we're going to do this same thing with a much bigger scale. We got these old fuel tanks on a farm, had them welded together, made one a lot bigger. They just happen to just fit inside each other. So here's another concept. Then you got, here's a whole nother way. The whole idea is to have a sealed chamber that seals off the oxygen. And this is what we've done right here with these three tanks. This tank, right here, you put the food scraps in here and you grind. This thing grinds them up, it sends them down this pipe, and the food just rots and it's sealed. The whole idea is to starve the rotting stuff of oxygen. It's anaerobic composting. Now I'll get into the science about that later. So after we cut the top off of our trash can, what you have left is a free hula hoop or a jump rope. You gotta get good at it first. Here's the top of our trash can. We're gonna use the Uniseals again. We've drilled a hole here. Got a Uniseal here, and pop it through. There may be a better way to tap into here, but I had a Uniseal, so I'm just gonna use it. They're not too expensive. Pop our PVC right through that hole, and that'll cause it to seal when it expands. We're gonna take these rotten apples and rotten vegetables and turn them into methane by grinding them up in this methane digester and letting them rot. So, first we're gonna turn on the water here. Plug it in, later we're gonna put a switch on it. Woo, this is nasty. This is a 3/4 horsepower in-sink aerator. Take a look down here as I'm grinding. So I just ground up a whole box of apples in like 30 seconds to a minute. Straight applesauce. The great thing about it, the great thing about using rotten vegetables is you're getting it before it's halfway digested. A lot of people use methane digesters. They'll throw cow dung in there, which is good. But that stuff is halfway already used. The cow's already been used. One time they hooked up a balloon to one of these cows, and that cow in one day filled up a balloon full of methane the size of the cow. So if your stuff is halfway digested, half of the methane's gone already. But if you can get it fresh, and nothing produces methane like anything with sugar in it. Here's some cantaloupes, apples. Produces way more methane than just grass will. So what you should do is you should go out to some of the local restaurants, you know, the ones right down the street, and see if you can make a deal with them to get their leftover food waste to put in your biodigester. It's way better than just using, you know, cow dung or you know, chicken waste. There's way more of it. We just picked up 800 pounds of rotten food waste. You know, if it was good, we'd feed it to the chickens, but the super rotten stuff we're just tossing in here, grinding it up, and it'll produce methane for 7 or 8 weeks. It'll produce a lot of methane within 2 weeks. Within 1 week, it's producing a lot of methane. The second week, a lot of methane, and then it just keeps going for about 7, 8 weeks. And by the time it's fully digested, it almost comes out like a clear liquid. This is our biodigester blueprint. These are our three IBC totes. 1, 2, 3. We wanted to build something that'll take 100 pounds of food scraps a day. Move it on through. Then the stuff that's been in there for a few days will come off the top, go back into the bottom, swirl around. The stuff that's been in here for a couple more weeks will come off the top. And then by the time it gets digested to the end, it's almost fully eaten up and turned into a nice clear liquid almost that we can use for fertilizer here. Last thing we're going to do is install our overflow valve. We're going to put a hole right here and put this Uniseal in right there, shove this into the tank, and then we can come in and pull off about 100 gallons of fertilizer, you know, whenever we want it. I'm gonna pull off all these burrs and make that real clean. Should use a really sharp hole saw if you can. I still haven't had any problems though with my dull ones. Fits in there like that. And we'll take this, fit it right in here. It's not easy. Oh! So we don't want this thing flexing. So we're gonna put zip ties on this side, zip tie to this side, so it's firm. We've already secured this side, so it won't go this way. Right now it still goes that way, so. You gotta have zip ties. I use zip ties all the time. Then you put your Uniseal in. It slides in just like that. It'll save you $50, a 3-inch bulkhead fitting. Sometimes you could spend anywhere from 30, 75 bucks. This is $5. And you can push this right through the Uniseal. Like so, and you'll want to turn this in. Like that. That'll give you an airtight seal. And it just sits right on the bottom. We'll add a funnel on top of this so you can pour the food waste right in.
All right. Wiring up our disposal here.
Here we are going solar. We're painting it black to soak up as much of the sun's heat during the day to keep that reaction going. And simultaneously heat the greenhouse during the winter time. In the summertime, we're gonna hate it. We'll probably have to cover it with a white sheet or something. Off the back of these tanks here, we've got the methane gas manifold. The manifold comes up out of the top of the tank, runs down, and collects methane off all three tanks here. Boom, boom, boom. And we've dry fitted this right now and put a marked a line so that when we go to PVC, it'll be easy. All right, now we're gonna get into the science of this thing. What we found out on accident, I guess nobody told us, we didn't read the last few lines. You can't just throw a bunch of rotten vegetables and rotten stuff and manure and whatever. You can't just throw it into a chamber and expect it to automatically just create methane. You got several different variables. And it's really easy to maintain. You just got to know some of the science, and we don't want to make it super difficult. But the whole idea is you got two different kinds of bacteria. one bacteria that creates, that, you know, eats your food and creates acid, the other that eats the acid and creates methane, the methogenic, you know, bacteria. And then you've got two different kinds of food. You've got low energy food, like what cows eat, grass, and then you got high energy food, like grain, and at the highest levels you got sugar. And what happens is, if you put too much high energy food in your chamber at once, if you feed the system too much, you'll end up getting too much acid producing bacteria, or too much acid. The acid bacteria will go crazy, produce a bunch of acid, and that acid is great. It's what the methane producing bacteria eat and create methane. The problem is it shoots the pH, you know, so high, or no, it shoots it so low, it shoots it down, you know, once you get past 6, you're done. Your methane bacteria start to die off, and then you kind of gotta start over and build back up that methane population. So the question is, how do you start a methane digester? What's the best way? And the best way is to start it with cow manure. Now, not chicken manure. Chicken manure has way too much high energy grain, stuff that hasn't even been digested, that it just goes right through the chicken's body. But the cow, they've been eating grass, and it's less likely to produce a spike in acid. So if you start right here, we've got a bunch of cow manure, a few hundred pounds of poop, stink, McNasty, that needs to be moved out of the truck, way over there. Can it be done? We believe that you are a part of the solution. Right here. And we just soaked it up, filled it full of water, and the whole idea is to start the process with this right here. Then you add, you know, 5% or whatever you can feed your deal a day, you know, 5% of food scraps. And then one thing you know is cows already have that methane-producing bacteria in them. You don't have to find it or wait on it or wait 3 months. One of the fastest ways to start your biodigester is to start with cow manure, horse manure, and then, you know, you'll be producing methane in no time, because all you do is just add a little bit of whatever. If you want to get going real quick, add some sugar. If you want to be real simple, just get into a routine, get a solid stock going, add the same amount of every day, or get some pre-rotting stuff going to where, you know, if you get a bunch of stuff rotting, you can pull off the same amount every day, because you may not get the same amount every day. You may get a bunch at once, have it pre-rotting, producing a bunch of acid, then take that and add it to your digester. And there's ways to automate this to where you're not like getting poop all over your hands, getting nasty, you know. There's ways to do this. So that's it for our intro on biogas digestion. We're going to have another video in the future where we pipe this methane gas into a water heater to heat the greenhouse, to heat the fish water. We're also going to pipe it into the house and use it on the gas stove. This here is the effluent off the digester. We're going to send it up to the University of Missouri and see what it's good for. It's supposed to be the process of digestion has cooked off any harmful bacteria, no chance of E. coli, but we're going to make for sure. We're going to get back with you on the results, tell you how fertile this stuff is, you know, if you have to dilute it, what it's good for. And yeah, that's it for this intro, and the next one will be a lot more dynamic. Okay, we've added some rubber bands around Elmo just to make sure she was pressurized. Yeah, buddy.